So the problem statement is, suppose you have a link, okay, a still link suppose. So this is a link and this has been pin jointed to two different suppose material or heat source, okay. So the first heat source is here. So this is, so this is at a temperature of 75 degrees Celsius. Okay, so 75 degrees Celsius, and suppose it is at 0 degrees Celsius. In terms of Kelvin, if you write, so how can I convert this temperature from degrees Celsius to Kelvin? Can anyone tell me? What is the SI unit of temperature?
Kelvin.
Yeah. So how to convert from degree Celsius to Kelvin? But how to convert from degree Celsius to Kelvin?
At 273 degrees. 273.
I have to add, right? With 75. Yes. Okay, good. I thought you forgot. Okay, fine. So 348 Kelvin, right? So here the temperature is 348 Kelvin, and here it is 273 Kelvin. Okay. So the problem here is, like, you have a link which is pin jointed at both the ends. So when the temperature of the first column has been increased to 75 degrees Celsius, so what will happen that along with this source, the link will also get heated up, and because of which, what will happen that this rod, this link will expand, okay? This will expand, and as it expands, so as it cannot move at both the ends because it's a pin jointed at both the ends, so some stresses will develop. So you have to now calculate what is the stress. Okay, this is your problem. You need to find out how much stress is developed because of this temperature variation of 75 degrees Celsius. Okay, so if you remember the physics of HSLC or probably class 10 11 12, so what is the change in length? You remember the equation for how, means if there is a change in temperature, how to find out the change in length? Remember? Anyone? Either you remember or not, so please tell me whether you remember it or you do not remember it. How to find out the change in length because of change in temperature? Anyone?
So alpha into del
P. Alpha. Okay, let me write here. Alpha into del T. Into what?
L.
Into L, correct. You remember it, that's very nice. So the change in length is basically proportional to, the change in length is proportional to change in temperature, and it's proportional to the actual length, right? So if I write it, so delta L is equal to, alpha is a proportionality constant, L into del T, right? So alpha is what? This is expansion coefficient. Right, and to find out, like in this problem here, as the temperature is changing, so what will happen that as it changing, because of this, this link will undergo some change in length, right? So that is, you can find out delta is equal to alpha L del T. And similarly, as this as the change in length is restricted, so you can find out delta L is the stress developed is PL by A. This equation you know, right? So if there is a change in length of del L, how much stress is developed? PL by A. So if I equate these two equations, you can find out PL by A is equal to alpha L del T, right? So LL cancels out. So the stress P by A is equal to stress. So stress is equal to alpha E into del T. So this much of stress should develop. Okay. Thermal conductivity of the material is suppose K is equal to 60.5 watt per meter per Kelvin. So thermal conductivity is nothing but how much change means how much energy is transferred because of a per meter length per degree Celsius. Okay, so that is given by K, thermal conductivity. So here then the Young's modulus is suppose E is 2.2 into 10 to the power 5 MPa, and the coefficient of thermal expansion, which is suppose 1.2 into 10 to the power minus 6 per Kelvin. Okay, and the change in temperature here is like we have 75 degrees Celsius plus 273. So this is the temperature is. You can see our temperature variations is 348 to 273 degrees Celsius. Here it is 348 and 273. And suppose the length of the link is 1 meter. Okay. Now and the area, cross section area of the link is 0.04 meter square. Okay. Now if I want to find out what is the change in length, so change in length is alpha L into del T. So if you do the calculation, is coming around like 9 into 10 to the power minus 5 meters. Okay. And from this change in length, we can find out what is the stress value. So the stress value is coming about del L into E by L, which is around 1.8 into 10 to the power 7 Pascal. Okay. So this is what actually we want to find out through ANSYS, like how much stress is developing in that link. So we want to find out this one using ANSYS software. Okay. Now there is a problem with the ANSYS is that, so we have discussed, there are different elements, right? So there are some structural elements, there are some thermal elements. So if I show you this link element, this link 33 element, if you see. So this element is basically used for thermal calculation, but it only take care of like the variation of change in temperature. Okay, but it doesn't take care of the stresses. Okay, here you can see. The link 33 is a uniaxial element with the ability to conduct heat between two nodes. It has the ability to conduct between two nodes, okay, but it doesn't have the capacity to like change or to transfer the stresses. Okay, so it's a deficiency of a link 33 element. But here in this problem we need to find out both. We need to find out how temperature is varying. And at the same time, we also want to find out what is the stress, because stress, for stress, there is some another element which we should have, and for temperature, we should have some another element. So two different elements should be there. Okay. So how to do this kind of problems where there is a, like you have to consider two different types of elements. So we will see. Okay. So now, first of all, in your ANSYS, you will first create the model. Okay. So let's go to the modeling part, go to model, create key points. Okay, we will create first key point. So I will select in active CS. So first node has a coordinate of 000, and the second node, as we have discussed, that the length of the element or the link is 1 meter, right? So here the x coordinate will be 1, and press OK. So we have the two key points over here. Then we will draw the lines, so straight line. So we will draw the straight line over here. So this is the link. Okay, so now we have to like select the material property. So let's go to the element type, add here. Probably I have already, let's delete this too. Okay, so let's add here. So you can, if you go to here, thermal mass. Okay, So in thermal mass in the link, you will see 3D conduction 33. This is basically link 33. Okay, you just select 3D conduction 33 and press OK. So you can see link 33 element has been added. Now close it. Then you can go to the real constants. Okay, so here we will assign the area. So select the link. Okay. Now for the area, as we have discussed over here, the area is like around 0.04 meter square. So we will write 0.04, press OK and close. So we have assigned the material and then the area of that material. Okay. Then after this, we will go to the material property and material models. Okay. Now we will go for directly like thermal. So first we will assign the thermal property. And now here you can see the conductivity and isotropic. So we will give the isotropic conductivity value that we have. So we are considering a material which has a conductivity of 60.5 watt per meter per Kelvin. So we will write it here 60.5. Okay. Now close this. After this, means we have assigned a material, we have assigned the area and all. So we can do the meshing now. So we'll go to the meshing tool, then size control, manual size, lines. So all lines, suppose the length of its element is 0.1, because the length of the element itself is of the link itself is 1 meter. So we are assuming like 10 divisions, so 0.1 meters. So click OK. So we have the divisions with us. Now we can do the meshing, lines, pick all. So we have now with us the element with the assigned, which is assigned as a link 33, and the area is 0.44. Okay. Then after doing the mesh, you will see here, go to the physics. Okay. Now the thing is, you have to define two types of physical environment. The first environment is the temperature, and the second environment is the stress. Okay, there is two environments are there. One is temperature environment and other is a stress environment. So we have to now define the environment. Okay, environment is like basically what is the condition, surrounding condition. Okay, so you will select the physics over here, then you will go to the environment, and here you will first select right. Okay, so now type the first physical title here. So suppose the first environment is temperature. So I will write temperature, temperature. Then I will place OK. Now what will happen, that it will just create an environment of temperature. Now as I have discussed with you, that your environment, like you have to do first analysis of thermal analysis, and after that you have to do a like a stress analysis, right? So environment, while I assign the environment, so it has like saved all your thermal data that we have assigned so far, like material type, the temperature, conductivity, the area. When I assigned it as an environment, we have written the environment as temperature, so it has saved it. Now, in the next step, what I will do, I will assign another environment, and where we will assign like material properties, the Young's modulus, the Poisson's ratio, etc. Okay. So for this, I have to first clear this environment. Okay. So it will not just clear it, it will clear the assignments basically. You cannot say clear the assignments, it will just create a new assignment. You can now assign another environment. Okay. So after writing the environment, you will just clear here and press OK. Okay. Now what we will do, we will now go for our second environment. That means for our stress analysis. So for stress analysis, first you need to change the element, because I have shown you that element 33 that we have is only basically has the ability to transfer the temperature. It doesn't work with the stressors, right? So for this, you have to go to the element type, then here switch element type you have to select. Now here in the drop down menu, you have different options. So you have to click thermal to structure. That means I'm switching my element from thermal to structural element. Okay. And I will press OK. After this warning will come up. So it will just ask you that the command has changed some of the element types, and please examine and not only the key point options, but also the real constant material properties and all, etc. So if you see in the elements, our link has been converted to link 180. Initially it was link 33, now it is link 180. Okay. Then it will go for material properties. Okay. So for material properties, go to the material models. Now we will give for structural, linear, elastic, isotropic. We have 2E. We can go for the E value is 2E11, and means Poisson's ratio is 0.3. And here, let's see whether E we have considered. Yeah, this is 2E. MPa, this is MPa Newton per mm square. Basically, if I convert it to Pascal, it will be 2E11 itself. So 2E11 and 0.3, press OK. Then also we will give thermal expansion coefficient here. So if when you click thermal coefficient expansion, select the second coefficient, select the isotropic. Here the value of the thermal coefficient is 1.2 in 10 to the power minus 6 per Kelvin. So I will type it here. 1.2 E minus 6. Okay, press OK. And now what I will do, a material model has been assigned, right? And then we will go for physics again. Now we will write it here again. So here I will type strut, S-T-R-U-T, strut. Okay. Now this is the second environment I'm talking about. The first environment is basically only considering the change in temperature and all and conductivity, and the second environment is considering the stress variations. Okay, after this we will go to the solutions, the analysis type, new analysis, which is static, is okay, fine. After this here I have to select the physics, but you cannot see the physics options over here, so you have to click here on unabridged menu. So when you click here, the physics will come up. So physics, so here you can see read. So we have assigned temperature and stress, so you will first select temperature, click OK. So now the temperature environment has been selected, and after this again go to the solution. We have to now assign the temperature, so we will go to define loads, apply thermal temperature on key point. So at this point we have a temperature of how much, 348 Kelvin, right? So select this particular key point, press OK, and here you will select a temperature, this 348, and press OK. So here we have assigned a temperature. Now we can go for a solution. Okay, solution, current LS solve. Okay, now first environment we have solved it, like what we have done, we have given a temperature at the initial key point and we have solved it how temperature is varying. Now because of this variation there will be like changes in length and all. Now we will apply that variation, change in length and change in temperature, to the second environment. Okay, so for this I have to first clear the first environment, that means I have to finish this, select finish. It will erase means all your other datas, and it will just keep the file where you have like saved your previous temperature data. Okay, now we will go to the solution again. Now we'll select the physics, read, we'll now select the strut. Okay, press okay. Now we have the strut environment. After this you will go to the solution again, and then you will select here define loads, then structural displacement, because we have seen in the question that in our problem as a strut it has the both ends are point pin joints, right? So we have to give that. So we have to select key point, or select the first key point, press apply. So I'm restricting all the means all of its degrees of freedom, so apply. Then for the other case I'm just restricting, it's only x, ux I'm restricting, others are allowing, because I do not want to have a variation in the x direction, other can be done. Press OK. So after this, you can, because the see here, you have to assign the temporizer. But the temporizer is just what the temporizer already we have assigned, right? So for this, I have to read the data of the previous calculation, right? So what you will do, you will go to temperature over here. Here you will see from thermal analysis. We have already done our thermal analysis, so I'll select it here. Now the file name and the results file. I have to select the result file. So where I can find it? When you browse it, you will see wherever you are doing your problem, where it may be a temporary file, or it may be, say, if you saved it, it will be somewhere other directory. But wherever you are working with, you can see there will be a file which has an extension name of RTH. Okay, so file.rth, this file you can see file.rth. So this file I have to select. So click OK. So this file will have all the thermal analysis data. Okay, so now press OK. Now another thing that we have, we have seen that the initial temperature is the variation in temperature is from 273 to 348, right? So the initial temperature we have not assigned, so that will be assigned as a reference temperature. So for this, you will go to the settings. Here you can see the reference temperature. So this will be 273. Okay, that means the first temperature one is 273, and temperature two we have already assigned. Press OK. And after this, we can go to the solve current LS. So it is done. Okay. Now we need to see the solution. So we will go to the element tables, define table, add, similar thing. Here you can see by sequence number, here LS, here you will select one, LS1. Okay, press OK, close. Now if I list element table, you can see LS1 over here, press OK. Now you please, you see this particular result table. Here the stress values are given. The stress value are minus 0.18 e to the power 8, right? So what we want to have, 1.18 into 10 to the power 7, that is exactly the same result that is showing here. It is like 1.8 into 10 to the power 7, right? So this is a stress that is developed because of this temperature variation, and as it is restrained by pin joints at both the ends, so thus we can find out the stresses in a link when it is fixed at both the ends,